the officers he has commanded.
When the National Police Service Commission embarked on a mission to vet senior officers last month, many expected that heads will roll. The police department has for a long time been bedeviled by numerous cases of improprieties, always coming on top when the corruption index is revealed. And for that reason, it was no surprise when the National Police Service Commission today announced the removal of three topmost officers from the office.
The main objective, ladies and gentlemen, of this vetting is to reclaim public confidence in the police service, to enable police officers who have been cleared during the vetting process to continue serving with the pride, confidence, and renewed vigor.
The Commission Chairman Johnston Kavuludi said the three officers, Jonathan Koskei, who was in charge of police reforms, Peter Eregae and Francis Okonya, were relieved of their duties due to their unsuitability to hold public office.
The following officers have been retired following the decision of the Commission that they be retired on account of competence and performance, in other words, suitability.
Others nevertheless escaped the sack, since the commission found no reason to terminate their services. The four officers who got a reprieve are John Ochieng Owino, William Saya, Peter Kavila, and Omar Shurie Abdi.
Undertaking the vetting, the commission will consider the officers' entry qualifications, their professional conduct and discipline, integrity, financial probity, and respect for human rights.
The commission disclosed that its decision was informed by revelations made during last month's vetting process, where numerous cases of corruption came up, prominent being senior officers receiving money from their juniors.
Vetting is intended to determine confidence, competence, suitability of police officers to continue serving in the National Police Service. Those found competent and suitable are to be retained in the service, while those found otherwise will be removed from the service.
Kenyans were stunned when, on more than one occasion, the officers affirmed the presence of large sums of money in their bank accounts that they could not account for. Eric Biegon reporting for the News Hour.